I'm standing in front of our Ammi planting. We have three different varieties planted here. These were overwintered. They were planted in seeded in late August and transplanted into the tunnel in mid-October. So they've overwintered and are just coming into bloom. This is May 29th. So these are getting ready to bloom long before our field varieties will be blooming. You can see this is Dara right here, just starting to color up. You can see how tall the plants are. These will have really sturdy stems, and we anticipate it getting even taller by the time it's in full bloom. This is Green Mist right here. It's a little bit behind the Dara, so it'll be a few more weeks probably before this blooms. And then right behind me here, this is White Dill. You can see this plot is in full bloom right now. It's been blooming for about a week and is definitely ready to harvest. A really nice kind of airy filler flower that's great to have for mixing into bouquets. You can see the long stems, wide flower heads, and just a really nice variety. All three of these varieties overwintered really well in our trial and should provide a lot of material for early spring bouquets. So Dara is one of my favorites, and for a few different reasons. One, I really, really love the range of colors on these blooms. So you can start with, some of them are almost white with just a little bit of a hint of pink on the blooms, and then they range up from to a little bit darker maroon and then to this really dark chocolate color. And so that range of colors is really nice when working into mixed bouquets, and it's a color kind of range or palette that I think works well with a lot of other flowers. The size of the blooms are really nice, and again kind of come in a range as the plot comes into bloom. So you can have, you know, you can harvest them when they're a little bit on the smaller side, but you can also, you know, what we've seen in this planting is that we will get blooms that are a lot wider than we would anticipate in the field too. So this one, you can see this is about 4 inches across. We have some others here. This one is 6 inches across, and then we've been harvesting off of this plot already for about a couple of weeks, and we've gotten some that are, you know, even larger than 6 inches across. So depending on how you're using them, they have the potential to really fill out a bouquet very nicely. Another thing that I really love about this variety, especially as it's growing in the tunnel, is that you can see how vigorous these plants are, and you can see how many stems are coming in here, but you can also see just how straight and clean these stems are, and that's one of the things that is really nice about this crop and this variety in particular. You can see how clean and straight that stem is. It makes it really easy to harvest a bunch out of this plot, and also they're, you know, ready to use right away. There's really minimal stripping or cleaning that needs to happen to these stems, so they're really great and versatile in that way as well. I'm here in our overwintered tunnel. I'm standing in front of our Ammi Green Mist. So this is the last to bloom of our Daucus and Ammi plantings that we had in here. We had three different varieties, and so White Dill was the first to bloom. It was really early, beautiful, bright, white, airy blooms. That was followed by Daucus, the variety Dara, which is still blooming behind this forest. And we're still cutting off of that. And then the last to bloom is the Green Mist here, which you can see I really want to show how tall it will get in a tunnel planting and just the size of these stems and blooms. This is a great end of the tunnel variety to have for putting into mixed bouquets. It goes really nicely with the rutabecchia that are blooming right now and the scabiosa. You can see long stems, wide blooms. Some get even a little wider depending on when you cut them. You can see here this one's a little bit more open and wider, but again, just a last peek at this variety, one of the last to bloom in our tunnel, and thank you for watching.